we can say that we live in the best of times, we live in the worst of times. That we human beings are magnificent. We are at a point now where we have the science, we have the technology, so that we could claim that that hunger, world hunger, is no longer a problem. You don't have a problem if you have a solution. And we do have the solution. We could, if we had the political will, if we had the moral capacity, we could say today, let's get rid of world hunger, and we could achieve it. At the same time, we live in the worst of times, that we have global warming, we have environmental degradation, we have food and water shortage. We have 8 people in the world who own half of the wealth of the human being. The inequities. So we have a predicament. Now, a predicament is different from problems in the sense that problems are solved, predicaments need resolve. They need a change in values, they need a change in intentions, they need a change in practices. That human beings have to live in the world in a different way. We, as human beings, have the cultural resources to stand up and address these problems. So in our time, we have to go to our cultural resources and find the assets that are necessary to have a world that we can pass on to the next generation, to my granddaughter. I did, my most recent stuff is called Confucian Role Ethics. And the real important idea here is the idea of a vocabulary. Confucian Role Ethics, a vocabulary. What am I talking about? I'm talking about a problem that we face today when it comes to understanding this long and rich Confucian tradition. What we have done, the people who introduced China into the Western Academy were missionaries. This was the civilization of Europe that had come to China to try to change the civilization of China and bring it to within the European orbit. And what they did was they translated the Chinese tradition in a way that is very familiar to Western people, but very distant from the Chinese tradition itself. When you translate Tian as heaven with a capital H, when you translate Yi as righteousness, righteousness is comporting yourself according to the will of God. Righteousness is a biblical term. When you translate Li as ritual. And then what we have is we have a Confucianism that is really shaped in the model of Christianity. When you translate Tao as the way with a capital W, the first thing that comes into a Christian mind is, I am the way, the truth, and the life. This is not Confucianism. When we let the tradition speak on its own terms, when we give it its own vocabulary, we look at the term Tao. Tao is written with the human being in the center. This is a human head, Tao. Is written with a human head. When we look at the term De, Tao De, De De, again, you have the human head, you have the human heart. The way is not his way. The way is the human way together. Ren Nang Hong Dao, Fei Dao Hong Ren. That the human being extends the way. It's not the way that extends the human being. That what we have done is we use Western concepts, Western theory, to understand the Chinese experience. And so the problem of understanding this Confucian tradition is a shared problem between modern Chinese who are educated within a conceptual structure that belongs to the West, and a Western tradition that is understanding China as a kind of aberrant Christianity. When we translate E as righteousness, to comport yourself according to the will of God, we have to understand that the best translators of the Chinese tradition, Marcel Grenet is the most distinguished French sinologist of the 20th century, and he says it very clearly. Zhonghua Jihui Bu Xu Yao Sheng Di, the linian, the gainian. That Chinese wisdom has no need for this idea of God. Tang Juni, one of the most distinguished contemporary philosophers, Chinese people have not embraced the concept of a transcendent God. And so when we push this kind of a conversation between Judaism and Confucianism, what we have to understand is these traditions, you'll see immediate resonance, but there is a very important difference. And it's difference, activating difference, that produces diversity, that produces new meaning.